And now, as a wonderful counterpoint to the young and entitled athletes in today's NBA, I give you Marquis Anthony. If you haven't read the front page story of today's Hartford Current, I strongly suggest you do so. Mike Anthony profiled the Quinnipiac freshman who somehow has managed to endure a lifetime's worth of pain, hunger, and hardship all in just the past 6 or 7 years. And as you'll see, he's come out of it all even stronger.
When we heard his story, it sort of attracted us to him even more. Dealing with what he's had to deal with, he's got to have something special inside him.
It's got to be his insides, because one day the world around Marquis Barnett's family just decided to fall apart.
I was in seventh grade, so I was about 12. And my mother met this guy, heard him fighting and fighting. So all of a sudden, like, everything just stopped. I ain't had no fighting or nothing, so like, I had a bad vibe. So like, the first thing that came to me was just go to the kitchen and grab anything.
Yeah.
So I went to the kitchen, grabbed a knife, and then I bust in the room, then I saw him on top of her, choking her. So I just stabbed him.
Yeah.
I tried to stab him in the head, but he like moved up, so I stabbed him in the back. That day, my mother realized that she had to get us out of there.
And so began the homeless stretch of Marquis's life. Shelter number one lasted only one night.
And the next day, he found us because my mother had a GPS in her phone and he tracked it down. We had an emergency, like, move.
Over the next 2.5 years, his family lived in 4 different shelters. One of them, in Queens, was a 6-hour round-trip commute just for Marquis to go to school.
I'm proud of him because a lot of people from his area, you know, probably wouldn't have made it this far, because it's easy to get caught up in stupid things, gang, drugs, you know, all that.
And still, it got worse. Last year, his little brother died in a fire at his grandmother's house.
I don't know if it can be a tougher road, I think.
I missed out on a lot, like a lot of parties, like normal teenagers do. Like, I missed out on a lot of that. So
The thing he had through the whole ordeal, I think, is his mother's love.
She was always strong for us. She always still made sacrifices for us. She is the strongest woman I've ever known in my life. I fed off of that, yeah. Like, that became me, basically.
So many excuses to fail, and yet here he is, succeeding. And not just despite his setbacks, but also because of them.
It's been neat to talk to him on a weekly basis about how he's doing allocating his money on his food budget. And he's a young man that could probably eat more at one sitting than any Quinnipiac student could eat.
I think what it will do is help him appreciate things, appreciate life.
Marquis is very appreciative and he's very humble, he's very grounded.
Yeah, you know, he takes criticism well.
Like, I just had to grow up fast.
He came from nothing and now he's something. He's at school, he has a scholarship, he's at school, he's getting good grades. He's doing everything that, you know, he's supposed to do, making his mother proud.
You spend even 10 seconds with him, you realize, or you actually forget that you're speaking to a college freshman. Again, folks, if you missed Mike Anthony's story, which gets into a lot more depth, a lot of stuff I wasn't able to touch on, that's on the front page of today's Current. It's also online at ctnow.com.